Okay, y'all, quick video. I only promised this video like about a year and a half ago, but better late than never. You see the title, Audacity. I've been using Audacity for years. Now, there's a plug-in. If you use this and you record with it, that's fine. If you want to save it as WMA or something like that, that's cool. If you want to convert it to MP3, don't panic, because when you select MP3, it's going to give a pop-up. Now, it's already on mine because I've been using this for years. It's going to give you a pop-up and say, hey, if you want to save it as an MP3, you need to download this plug-in. It's say, just click on the plug-in, pick on your computer where you want it to go. You ain't got to screw with it no more. That's the last time you'll see that pop-up. So then whenever you, now this Audacity is an audio recorder. That's the only thing I use it for. Been around for years. This is very good. Very good. I have zero issues with it. It's simple. It's sometimes the simplest things are the best. Yeah, you can get a big soundboard. Yeah. Sometimes you just want to record the sound that you see on your computer screen. Okay. Now, y'all see what I got on the screen. I've been subbed to this guy for a long time, Mr. Vinyl Obsessive. And I have this album. I even commented to him on it. I have a copy, but I didn't know any better days. I didn't keep the vinyl clean and sure as heck didn't know what tracking and counterweighting was. That's turntable talk. It plays, but not like your mind got some pops in it. I damaged the record. It's playable, but it's not audio grade because I didn't have the tracking set right and playing it for year after year after year. Sort of trebled and fell off and the background silence is gone. So, but anyway. And you say, yeah, but now I'm all over it with my nitty gritty record cleaner. You know, I didn't had that for decades, but this old stuff. Anyway, quick demo so you can see, find what you're going to record, news, music, whatever, audio. Now, also, I already got Audacity open. It's just in the background. Simply, a lot of people know, and I like Mick, but a lot of song, you know, I think it's Money Too Tight to Mention. That's no, either it's Holding Back the Years or Money Too Tight to Mention. But that song is a redo that came out decades ago. I like them both, but I love Simply Red. I do. Alan Parsons Project is one of my favorite groups on the planet. Yeah, I said it. Been that way for a long time. Now let's go. Already had it open in the background. The settings is what everybody, first you go to Audacity. You can put it in your search engine, Audacity, AUDACITY.com. Hit enter. It's going to pop up. It's freeware. Don't cost you nothing. Download it. Find a place on there. Go in. Set your stuff up. Hello. Export. See, now, until you download the plugin, see where it says export MP3? When you hit that, it's going to tell you that you don't have this plug-in that you need. And it's going to tell you where to get it. You click on it. You download it to your computer. That's the last time you'll see that pop up, okay? Go to the help section, and it has a manual built in, so it can tell you everything. But just for the person that got a video, something on the screen they want to record, this video is for you. You just heard it. It's a video, Alan Parsons Project, Voyager, you know, from Mr. Vinyl Obsessive or whoever, and you want to report it, let me show you the basic settings and you will get the exact same sound that you hear coming through your speakers. Okay. See this first tab? Let's start for, we're going to go left to right. Yeah, I'm talking fast, but y'all can go back and look at it. MME, Windows Direct, and Windows WASAPI, WASAPI. That's the one you want. Stay on there. Mine's already set. This will show you all the recording devices, all the audio devices that you have in your system. You see, I got NVIDIA, the TV voice meter, that's software, microphone manipulation software, sound software, speakers, PDIF, you know, digital audio, the microphones that's plugged into this computer. Don't worry about none of that stuff. To get to record, now it says speakers, but you're not recording from your speakers. It's recording the audio inside your system from your sound card that's going to your speakers, okay? Now, if you wanted to use this to record the audio of your microphone, just click your microphone. You know what I'm saying? Because it'll show your microphone, or you got your microphone running through voice meter, like I do. Then click your auxiliary output or click the microphone and go ahead. And then whatever you say after you hit the record button will go into your computer and it will be recorded to your hard drive. Okay. But in this case, you know, already I want to record the audio that's going into the sound card. Okay. Mono or stereo, self-explanatory. If it's a stereo recording, I want it in stereo. If it's a mono recording, I want it in mono. Okay. It really is that simple. Speakers, you know, same thing. Leave it on your speakers because that's where the feed is going to. Don't screw with none of this stuff. You see your recording volume. If you record it and you play it back and it sounds lower than what the original source is, just delete it. Go back and bump your recording volume, but don't max it out because you're going to see a meter here once we get the going. And you want to keep it in the green and with a little bit of yellow. If you start getting into the red, then your system is clipping and you're going to get that digital clip. And digital clip is way more painful on the ears than an analog clip. Trust me. Any sound engineer can tell you that. But anyway, keep your recording level where it's, you know, it's just going out of the green into the yellow. You don't want it too low because then you get background noise, you know, the hiss in the background. You want to keep the recording audio just high enough where it covers the background noise, where it's inaudible, but not enough where your audio is clipping. Okay. Now, this is the way I do it because I got to cheat because you can edit this at the end. I'm not going to make y'all sit through this whole recording. Okay. I'm going to cut it out. I'm just going to show y'all the beginning and then y'all come back and see me saving it to my hard drive. Okay, let's go. Watch this. Now, this is what I do first because it pops it down as soon as I hit record. Don't worry. But Nick, I'm going to have a big gap at the front before the music starts. Ooh, no, you're not. Look, I like to keep about a second, maybe 2 second gap before the music starts, because if you're putting this on MP3 or recording it to a CD and you put it on shuffle or something, if you make the gap too small, it may count the whole thing as one song. But if you put a definite gap in there, you know what I mean? Your system, something that most modern systems, that's not a problem. But some people use old equipment like my janky ass because it works. But anyway, I like to keep a 1, maybe 2 second, second and a half gap before the music starts. But that's me. Now watch this. It's going to drop down once I hit record. So how do I know it's recording? Hold on. Hold your simmer down. Hold on. Watch. Record. Click. See the meter at top. Okay, I just stopped it there. You see how it was just barely getting into the red? I would knock my recording level down just a little bit. I'd knock my recording level down just a smidge. But I'm just using this as a demo. Now let's say, all right, I'm done recording. I didn't delete this and went back and I knocked my recording level down. If I listen to it first and if it don't clip through my system, cause it barely touched the red, I'd leave it alone. But if it did do that, when it go, yeah, no, then delete it. Knock your recording level, knock your recording down just poquito, just a little. You see your little meter there, see where it says recording level? Just bring it down a little bit. Bring it down a little bit. But you should be okay. It's rare that you have to mess with it, but if you do, you do, okay? Playback. Now, if you want to do some of that funny stuff when you got somebody talking and you got Omega, you can play kick up the playback speed, or you want to do that truth teller, that sipping on some scissor, you know, you can slow it down, the playback speed. So you want to go truth, or you want to, that's the Shangri-Las. The name of the song is called Remember by the Shangri-Las, but it was famous then. Then Aerosmith redone it in the 70s and it blew the hell up. Now, for some odd reason, it's a hit and kids think it's something new, and that song came out before I was freaking born. Anyway, watch this. Okay, so now, all right, you're done recording and you hit file and you hit export. Why did I say import? I'm not adding it. I'm taking it out. Gonna pop up and for you to download that deal that I was talking about. Once you got it downloaded, you're not gonna see that anymore. So you hit that, bam. It opens up the window where all your audio files, whatever you put in when you set up. If you didn't put something in when you set up, see this box right here where it says create new folder. If you don't have an audio, if you don't have a folder where you got all your music at, now's the time you can create one. It's real simple. If you do have one and it's not showing, just either hit the drop down arrow or move up and find your hard drive if you have multiple drives. And then you can click the folder that you're using and have, so you, when you save it, that's where it'll go. Okay, and y'all see I got a ton of crap on here. Well, not crap, music. All right, what? Alan Parsons Project. And I don't have Voyager on here, so as soon as I hit Voyager, it should. Okay, now Voyager's on there. MP3 files, leave it alone. Quality, normally, if it's 160, 192, 144, I won't go no lower than 128. The smaller the kilobytes per second is, kilobytes per second is, the sound quality deteriorates, but it takes up, it's a smaller file, takes up less hard drive space, less disk space or thumb drive space or whatever. The larger the file, it keeps the quality of the sound, but it's a much larger file. It takes up a lot of space. If you got a small hard drive, I would stick to the 160, 144. If you listening through a phone and some little whiz bang headphones, I would even go to 128, but you know, but if you listening through a pretty high def system, you probably already know this stuff already. So y'all can just keep going. Me, I leave the stuff at 160, 144. I will not go under 128. Okay. Now we hit save and you see this window and you put in artist name. Cause this is how the metadata tag is, how you find it in your system, how your MP3 player finds it in your system, how your car stereo finds it in your system. If you leave this blank, if you've ever been playing a homemade CD or a music uploaded to MP3 thumb drive and the music's playing, but when you look up for the album, it says no artist, and then it cycles, no track title, no album, no track number, no, right? That's because the metadata is blank. This is the time for you to go. If you wanted to cycle with the letter T in your search, then put the Alan Parsons Project. If not, just put Alan Parsons. Because how many groups is The Who, The Alan Parsons Project, The Oak Ridge Boys, The. I like The. Hit it. This is the day your life will never. I like the The Infected. It was my favorite the album project. And if you know the info, you should, you know, you can put it in. If not, go, if you want it to be right, Google the song. Me, I, you know, You know, you can, you know, a lot of time the people, if you're getting from something on there, you know, it's on here. Pyramid, 1978. Tracks number 1, 2, and 3 in this case. But I'm not going to, so I'll just put, you know, track title, Voyager, What Goes Up, The Eagle Will Rise Again. Even though I'm not saving this, I'm just doing this. Track number, you know, I hate to put 1, 2, and 3 because that'll confuse the hell out of the system anyway, because most people just do it by one song. But if you want to do that, fine. 1978, genre, progressive rock. Comments, you know, that's whatever the hell you want to put. Now, if it's something you record through your microphone, you put your name, track title. You can leave all that other shit blank. The year you done it, leave that blank. Comment, me and Truth Teller ganging up on super sly, you know, some shit like that. You can hear a lot of, psh, ow, ooh, ow, hey, stop, psh, psh. So get me out of this contract. Psh, psh. You hear a lot of stuff like that. Then you hit add, click, and when you hit add, it'll stick all that stuff to the file you just downloaded. Then you hit okay, and you'll see a meter go across the screen showing a progress meter where it's saving the song to the folder that you pick. Boop. And when it's done, you can go to that folder. You can play it back. You can burn it to a disc. You can put it on a thumb drive. You can play it back through the audio system on your computer. That's it. Like I said, I don't want to hit save because I don't want to have to go back in and delete it and all this other stuff because I'm not trying to save it. But okay, I know I'm only a year and some change late. I'm sorry, but there it is. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask me. Now, don't be asking me, well, how much, what is the footprint of the Audacity system? And is there, when is the last bug upgrade? Yeah, okay, look, you need to go to their website and figure that out. I'm just showing you the basics of how to use it. You want to record something that's on your screen. Because I had a gang of people ask me, there's the answer, okay? Toodles. Bye.